Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Kavinsky's Tutorials. Today I'm going to take a little look at the Audiothing SX1000. This just came out for desktop, iOS, iPad and iPhone, and you'll find pricing information and stuff in the pinned comment of this video. So this is apparently a faithful emulation, but with some extras of the 1978 JEN SX1000. So that was a mono synth, but this has polyphonic option. And it's got a lot of other cool stuff as well, like this nice arpeggiator, which has a free rate option, as well as synced, which I really appreciate. And nice built-in effects, which can be moved around, by the way. And if you're familiar with the original, you'll see there are a bunch of new things here as well. So I'll mention those as I go through the video. So let's have a listen first. I'll just give you about a minute worth of demos, and then we'll go through and just walk through the UI and clarify what's been added into this that the original didn't have. So it's very simple synth, but nice sound, definitely. So we'll take a little walk through the UI and let's, you know, hear what everything sounds like. So this is the init patch. I've just turned glide off. And I've got it set to monophonic. So here we just got, you know, stuff like tuning and changing the octave of the oscillator and vibrato. And we got three waveforms, saw, square, and pulse. Now, with the saw one, note that down here you've got a little extra control which can change the shape. And with the pulse width, or with the pulse waveform, we then control pulse width here. Let me turn down the pulse width modulation first. Okay, so controlling the pulse width, and then we can dial in pulse width modulation. So that's linked to this LFO here. So here we got the LFO speed, and we can have synced or free. It's on free at the moment. And down here we've got the waveform shape. So slightly weird UI layout. This, I think, is to preserve, you know, the way the original looked as much as possible. A bunch of extra stuff's been added along the bottom. So let's try square waveform there, for example. I'll also just turn up the filter frequency. There we go. So yeah, pulse width modulation is using that LFO. And then here the level for the oscillator. And here your glide control. Then here we've got our filter, a really nice sounding filter, I think. Now let me turn down this pulse width modulation. So we can control here the amount by which the LFO will modulate the filter. And here how much this envelope will modulate the filter. So So I think everybody's probably pretty familiar with how that works. Here you can add noise, white and pink noise, and here you've got a level control for that. Here you've got your VCA, so output volume, the attack, the decay, sustain and release. And then here you've got a sub-oscillator, so the original didn't have this. The original also wouldn't have given you choice over these different LFO types, by the way, like you have here. So let's play a higher note. So let me add in the sub-oscillator. Nice. So the original did not have any velocity tracking. So here you can dial in how much it will respond to the velocity of your input notes. Then here you can also open the filter more with higher velocity notes. Then here you can just, if you're using polyphony, you can set the note priority, or for the monophonic as well. It will be the highest note, the last note, or the lowest note that gets priority. You've got your bend range here. You can set legato, and if you want, you can make it so that there will only be glide happening when you're doing legato. Here, we already demoed this saw shape thing, and you've got key tracking as well if you want for the filter. Let me turn off the sub-oscillator. Play something higher there. All right. Here you can put in, you can turn on or off whether it has this noise off the chip, which is subtle, I think, but I think I hear something. I think so. Down here then, if you want, you can have a keyboard even in this, inside the plugin. You've got your ARP here. So as I said, the ARP is really nice for me because it has this free rate option, and I just love it. That is so fun to play with. So turn it on here. And if you want, you can turn on hold as well. So it'll just hold the input notes. Now I'm not touching the keyboard. And you've got your, you know, usual arpeggiator stuff here. Okay, so you know, up, up, up and down, down or random. You can make it reset the arpeggiator. Every bar, every two bars, every four bars or not. And you got your range here. You can make it follow the velocity of your input notes. Let's say you're playing them with a keyboard. So here, if you set it here, it will respect the velocity of each note you input. So if you have, you know, one note that you play in very softly, it'll keep that velocity for that note. Playing another note very loud, it'll keep that velocity. Or you can use it, use the last note that you input that will set the velocity for the whole ARP. You can also tell it what note order to use. Will it use the note order that you play in, or will it follow the pitch? Lowest to highest or whatever. Then here you have this little thing, chord. So if you play in a chord, let me just bring the rate down a little bit. I'm gonna just lower the pitch. So I'm just playing three notes. So that's just your normal up arpeggiation, and here's with the chord. That's fun. Then the effects section. So we've got the tape echo, and let's just switch over to something else. Let's use this. So I'll turn these ones off first. And so here we just got the tape echo on. I'll just turn that off for a second. So put on the tape echo. And, you know, this is just the audio thing, space echo. Again, you know, you can have it synced or free. And you got feedback control and your mix level and so on. Then you got wave folder. Turn the tape echo off. So this is based on the Audiothing Things Fold plugin, I think. Well, I'm not 100% sure. It's not really as raw as that at all. I don't know. Then here we have a flanger. Let me just change this to the init patch. And I'll just bring the frequency up a little bit. So nice sounding flanger. And then here we have this spring reverb. So I'll just go back to that bit more plucky one for that. Sounds good, I think. So, yeah, and then you got, you know, a bunch of presets. I'm not going to demo presets in this video. I'm going to keep it short. I'm sure someone else will be doing a demo of those. Probably, I don't know, Doug over at the Sound Test Room might do that. So you can go and check that out. So let's finish off there. I hope you found this useful. I hope it helps you make a good purchase decision. I won't go into stuff in this video like the randomizer. Well, we can listen to a little bit of the randomizer output. So it's going to be pretty hit or miss, but you can make it more likely that you'll get hits by locking things. You know, find a preset that you like. Find a preset you like. Let me turn that lock off. Locks, you know, some of the main controls. And just like, let's say I just lock everything and leave the effects to be allowed to be randomized. Whoops. I can't lock some. Can't lock all of these things here. Like this, not letting me lock that. I think. So now let's just try randomizing. So, you know, now we're just getting the effects, and maybe the ARP is also randomizing. Yeah. And so then we're much more likely to get output that we like. So really enjoyable. Anyway, if you found the video useful, please remember to smash the like and subscribe if you're into iOS music. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you, guys. Take it easy.